turn to page number 30. You can see the poem here. So just follow the lines where I am reading. So the poet's name is not given here, children. That is anonymous. Anonymous means a person's name or identity has not been revealed here. So let us see what the poet wants to say here. So children, this poem is about the about the war between the two countries. So the poet is sad to think about the illogical fights between the nations, between two nations or between two countries. And also the poet in the poem is saying that many things are similar. According to the poet, many things are similar, like curve of smile, pain of losing dear ones, sky, stars, freshness of air, fragrance of flowers, etc. Many things are similar. Then why do two countries fight? The poet wants to know here. Okay. And as a children, so what is the what we are going to gain when there is a war between two countries? So what happens there? So there will be a lot of destruction, sorrow, bloodshed everywhere, isn't it? So nothing we are going to gain from them. Then why do two countries fight? So according to the poet, many things are similar, isn't it? So as I said, curve of smile maybe, and then we all share the same sky, and then stars, sunlight and all. Then why and what for do two countries fight? The poet wants to know here. So that is why there's a question mark you can see here. Why and what for the poet wants to know. So children, page number 13, then just follow the lines where I'm reading. It is the same curved smile on everyone's face. It is the same pain of losing your dear one's embrace. Embrace means hug. It is the same sky, same stars, same sunlight. Then why and what for do two countries fight? So the question mark you can see at the end. So the poet is asking, then why and what for do two countries fight there? So as I told you, there's a same everyone is having everyone will feel the pain when you lose your dear ones, and then curve of smile, and then sky, stars, everything we share the. Everything is similar then. Then why and what for do two countries fight? The poet is asking here. Same is the happiness flowers scattered everywhere. Same is the happiness flowers scattered everywhere. Same touch of air that tells yes I am here. Same freshness, same fragrance, same delight. Then why and what for do two countries fight? Again the poet is asking. Same happiness, same is the happiness flowers scattered everywhere. And then same touch of air that tells yes I am here. Same freshness, same fragrance, same delight. Then why and what for do two countries fight? The sorrow is deep that dwells in my heart. Dwells means what? Lives. The poet is saying that the sorrow is deep that dwells in my heart, that lives in my heart. When the poet thinks about these things, when he think about the war, what happens after the war, so he's sad to think that way. And why don't we unite to give a fresh start? So the poet is asking, why can't we unite? Why can't we forget everything? And why can't we unite and start, give us a fresh start there? He's asking, it is the same work that destroys. It is the same work that destroys nations overnight. Then why and what for do two countries fight? So the poet is asking. So again, you can see the question mark here. So the poet wants to know, so why can't we unite and give a fresh start there? So because of war, what happens? So after thinking that one, the poet is very sad, and then he's also saying that the sorrow is deep that dwells in my heart, that lives in my heart after thinking everything. So even though everything is similar, so there are a difference of opinions there, because of that it happens. So why can't we forget? Why can't we unite and give a fresh start, he's asking there. So that is the summary of the poem, children, here. I hope you have understood. Read the poem. Okay. First para you need to by heart. Okay, children. I'll ask you in the online class also. So by heart the first para, children. Okay. See you in the next class. Thank you.